Alright, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, I've made it almost halfway through the summer without breaking my wrist, so I've been demoted to the human forklift. Yes, they just have me lifting things around. But we have been working on a prototype skateboard press. And this is actually a concept that we had come up with based on dirtboards. Because dirtboards have no, you know, effective kingpin angle that's been built into the trucks. It's just a standard 90-degree channel that comes off the deck. And then the deck is actually what defines the kingpin angle. So that's what's going to basically control your turning radius. So we came up with that concept and then decided that if we took our trucks, which are designated at a 17-degree, you know, kingpin angle because of the channel, if we flip it around and have a negative kingpin angle and then change the wedge on it to such an extreme that it actually would give it a different rake, then we can effectively get a different kingpin angle, if that makes any sense whatsoever. Basically, we have this wicked cool looking skateboard deck and we've flipped the trucks around backwards.
Yeah.
So we're going to attempt to make an actual working skateboard prototype. This is just something we've thrown together to check our tolerances.
Yeah. And the benefits of this setup here is, see, it acts as a drop deck, but you can see it's not quite a drop deck, you know? It keeps the deck lower. In fact, we're afraid it's going to drop it too much.
Yeah. It could be so low that we're going to have to minimize the width of the deck so it doesn't drag, or come up with a way of actually getting more concave out of the deck to pull the edges away from the pavement even more. Mm-hmm. Which, you know, is a challenge, but could also be a really easy, fast way of making you know, drop decks for our skateboard trucks.
But aside from being just fast and easy, we save a lot of, like, when you make a drop deck, you know, you typically have, like, a couple inches of transition space that's neither, you know, it's not a standing platform, and it's just keeping your wheels farther apart. If you want a short wheelbase, it's really eating into your platform where you stand.
Right. So we're actually maximizing our
usable area.
Yeah. And I'm really excited because this is going to be a really fast skateboard. Yeah. It's going to be really low to the ground, and it's only going to have about a 13 symmetric kingpin angle.
Yeah.
So it's not going to have a really large, or it's going to have a huge turning radius, which is going to make the board ride phenomenally well at speed.
Yeah.
So we might be getting back to you later with an update that was a complete failure, but so far we're excited. Here we are executing the new technique, the plastic encasement. It's like we're making mummies around here now.
Placing our pins to hold the wood in place.
And it keeps our wood nice and fresh.
Yeah.
So that we don't get the green, fuzzy croissant in the back of the refrigerator kind of wood, you know?
Glue.
Okay. Riley's gonna clean up the glue now. When building presses of this sophistication, there's gonna be some cracking and separation to be expected.
Especially when you use clamps like this on it.
There we go.
Alright, we just got all the clamps on. That is some pretty extreme curvature on that. It's almost 30 degrees right there. Now we just use wood screws to bind this plate on against it to make sure the plies stack and just up nicely.
Look at. Did it move the wood at all?
No.
Not really?
Well, I mean, it pulled it down nice and snug, but it didn't, like... I thought you meant move.
I mean,
as, like, slip.
I mean, to make it so the curve is more...
Oh, yeah.
More defined curve?
Yeah, definitely. It's more crisp.
See that? Look at that.
That's nice.
Yeah, but look how it's, like, coming up.
Yeah, it's a pretty extreme transition. It's 2D.
Incredible. And then feel stick your hands underneath because you feel this concrete.
Whoa. That is pretty intense. Is that 3/4 inch?